Hi users, I'm Eddie with Sangfroid Web Design. Today I'm going to give you a quick tutorial on how to add a user to your Google Cloud project. This is useful if you're not very technical and somebody needs you to get an API key for something like Google Maps, etc. You'll have created a project and set up the billing for that, and now you want them to get in there and be able to help you tweak the settings or get information they need to add functionality via that project. So first I'm going to go here to a browser window. I'm at Google, and I happen to know the URL is console.cloud.google.com. You can see it there, but also another quick, easy way is just type a Google Cloud Console to Google search, and it'll give you a link to it right there. I'm going to start with one of the first pitfalls I see a lot of people run into. You'll notice my icon up here. That is my personal Google account. It's the default with my Google Chrome. So I'm going to need to switch that to the account that I know is used for the project I want to do. So sometimes users go and they don't find the project, and it's because they're not in the right profile. So now that I've switched to the correct profile, I can hop over into the console. And you can see it's got the projects up here. This is the project that I was last using, so it's what I'm currently in. I'm just going to click on that and it will show all my projects, and I can pick some project. Let's just pick this random Joni API project. And now I can click over here with three dots, go to project settings, and I just click this I am button. And now you can see that it's got us as the default users of this, but I want to add another user so that they can help me with this project when needed. Okay, so now I'm just going to click this grant access button. I'm going to type in my work email here. So now I'm going to come down to the select role and I'm going to click that. You can see that Google is very granular about how you can control what roles a person has. But to make this easy, you can just say basic and give somebody editor access. That basically doesn't make them the owner, but they can pretty much do all the technical stuff that you're going to need them to do. Now I'm just going to go ahead and click the save button. And now we can see that this other user is now here. So now when that user logs into their own Cloud Console account, they'll be able to click on this projects button and be able to find the project through their project menu. And then they can get what they need, make changes, or help you in any way needed. So that's it. As you can see, it's pretty straightforward. It can be a little tough to figure out, but hopefully this video helps somebody. We appreciate you watching and definitely appreciate you following Sangfroid Web Design for more WordPress and general tips. Thank you.